modern times, there was a competition that took over the world from this green and pleasant land between man, woman, and a group. From the four corners of this empire they came. To be granted glory by the ones who be known for eternity as the Judges!
What was the most embarrassing moment of all?
In the room at the time.
What did the duvet?
It felt terrific.
Can I take these off?
Bring me my chariots of fire!
I just want to blow the out of everybody.
Bring me my microphone!
You could be one to watch. It's three yeses.
We love you!
Yeah!
Oh my God!
Bring me the final wave of auditions!
Good luck, good luck.
Follow your spirit! And upon this charge cry, on for Connie and the Extra Factor!
I've got a bad feeling about this already.
I like ITV2.
What a great guy!
Auditions may have ended over on ITV1, but with over 250,000 people to see, there's just so many you miss. Thank goodness that we're here to fix that, because there's some treasures that just shouldn't stay buried. Speaking of which...
My name's Ottavio Donato Colombro, I'm 18 years old, and I work at the customer services department at Tesco's Newbury.
Oh, Ottavio, italiano.
Yes.
Ah, buongiorno, Ottavio.
Ciao, come stai? I've been singing roughly since the age of 12 years old when I received my first award for musical proficiency for vocal potential.
You're very smart.
Thank you.
Like it when a man dresses up.
I've done many concerts around Newbury. I've performed in all of the Mayor's concerts, and I performed the Marks and Spencer's Christmas Do. I took part in our version of Newbury's Got Talent. I came third.
Can you win this thing, do you think?
I believe I can, yes.
Good!
I would say I'm definitely well known in Newbury. I get recognised by shop workers and local news agents. I get recognised in the Corn Exchange, which is our local theatre. I get recognised in my bank by my bank advisor, and there's nobody in Newbury who doesn't know me.
Oh, you've got to go for your audition, I believe. So, good luck, good luck.
Thanks,
and I will see you later.
Thank you.
You smart, dapper man.
What's your name?
Ottavio Colombro.
And where are you from, Ottavio?
Newbury, Berkshire. My parents are Italian.
Oh, okay. And how old are you, Ottavio?
18 years old.
And tell me something about you.
I came second in a national singing competition.
Which one?
Open Mic UK.
What's with the glasses?
Just part of my image, really.
Okay. Which is, what is your image?
I would say like Usher.
Good. And what are you going to sing?
And I'm telling you, Dreamgirls.
Oh, no. Okay, good.
And I am telling you, I'm not going. You're the best judge I'll ever know. There's no way I could ever go. No, 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 no. No, 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 no way. Oh, I'm living without you. I'm not living without you. You see, there's just no way, there's no way. Tear down the mountains, yell, scream and shout. You can say what you want, I'm not walking out.
Okay, Louis, what do you think?
Ottavio, it was very different. It was a totally different rendition of the song. I think the song was a little bit too big for you. But you are very theatrical.
I can sing another song.
No, thank you. What do you think, Cheryl?
I'm still a little confused by the Usher comparison.
That audition, I mean, certainly it was the worst version of that song I've ever heard. By a mile. And I'll tell you what it was like. It was almost like I'd walked into my accountant's and suddenly he'd had a couple of drinks and started to sing to me. And you just don't have anywhere near that kind of voice for that song.
Can you try one more song?
No.
One more. Amazing Grace.
No.
I believe I've got the talent side of it.
Not as a singer. Not with that kind of voice.
I'm taking that.
Bud?
I'm not taking that. No way. No way.
I don't really have much choice.
Are you saying I can't sing then?
Yes. I am.
We're looking for somebody who's going to sell millions of records. You're never going to do that.
No.
No, wrong. 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 So wrong.
OK, Louis, yes or no?
I'll tell you, it's a no.
Cheryl?
No.
Thank you. I do strongly believe the judges have made a mistake.
I'm not taken back.
Attitude.
I'm still going to carry on performing in Newbury, doing the gigs, and just reassessing my tactics and trying again with a different route.
So while Octavio heads back to Newbury to assess his tactics, I'm off to assess the London auditions with Simon.
Hi.
Oops, sorry, wrong door. How's it going?
I wasn't, you know, as optimistic about coming to London as everybody else. The city's got nothing to do with anything. You know, it's just luck, right? You never know what's going to happen, and you have a long day. It's fine, it's OK. You're reaching the end, you've had enough. Then out walks this girl. What do you do for a living? I'm a horse dentist.
What do you do for a living?
I'm studying to be an equine dentist. I have horses teeth.
What?
What are you going to sing? Whitney Houston. Here we go again. And she was fantastic.
Joe Beatlestone.
Yeah.
He filled me up. He gives me love. More love.
I like it when that happens.
How often is it that you get one of those here we go again moments and then you're like, no?
To be surprised now.
To that extent.
It's rare.
Wow.
Yeah.
I've got to ask you, why does Louis keep asking about people's hobbies?
What are your hobbies? What are your hobbies? What are your hobbies?
What are my hobbies?
Ask Louis.
Is there some sort of private joke?
No. He just asks a weird question.
Where are you going on your holidays this year?
I asked Simon, why does Louis keep asking people what their hobbies are? Is this some in-joke? He told me to ask you.
He asks a lot of silly questions too.
What's your favourite fish?
When somebody walks on, we ask them their name, their age, where they're from.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of all predictable. I try and find out something more about them.
Hobbies is
good. Well, I can't tell you more about something. I enjoy life.
That's
I love
a hobby
life.
Then, is it?
It is. I love life, I love music, I love people. I love eating and drinking and singing and dancing.
You're a gregarious man, Louis.
I like it.
What a great guy. We like you too, Louis. But we're going to like part two even more.
I'm going home.
Sorry, Louis. Haven't seen enough? Want to see what's coming up in part two?
Feel like a dream come true for me.
Slight overreaction, but okay.
Everybody's going up.
Green door, should I have me headwinds?
Three yeses.
Extra factory.
I used to be in Zulu tribe. What's so funny about that?
This is The Extra Factor, and if you're enjoying the show, may I be so bold as to suggest you tune in to a similar show called The X Factor, which is on before this show every week on a small channel called ITV1. Apparently it's quite good. And I've heard they've had some pretty good acts on that show, especially our capital city, London, known for being the epicentre of talent, which is why our next contestant is going to have to knock it up a gear and show music is their life. Maybe someone who can play keyboard and synthesizer.
Music is my life. I play keyboards and synthesizer.
What are the chances?
What's your day job? What do you do usually?
I work for Asda's.
They do that, don't they?
Yeah,
that's it. You do it well. Do it again. Lovely. So is there a lovely lady in your life?
Yes, there is.
Oh. Sorry, girls. Who's that? Who's
that? Her name's Helen and she works for Tesco.
No! Stop it! Oh, my God!
So
you're in an Asda-Tesco relationship.
Yes, yes. For the wedding, we've decided to do a supermarket theme. we decided that her family would be dressing in Tesco's uniforms, my family would be dressing in Asda's uniforms, Vic will be in Sainsbury's uniforms, Organist will be in Marks and Spencer's, the Ushers in Waitrose, and we thought all the friends of the family will be in Morrison's. It's a big, fat supermarket theme, so it'd be very colourful. To win X Factor, it'd be like a dream come true for me, really.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Matt Lewis!
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Matt.
And what do you do for a living, Matthew?
I work for Asda.
Which department?
Fruit and veg.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's popular right now?
Oranges at the moment, so...
Yeah? Are you going to sing a ballad or an up-tempo song?
I'm going to sing Sorry Seems to Be the Hardest Word.
OK.
What I gotta do to make you love me? What I gotta do to make you care? What do I say when it's all over? 'Cause sorry seems to be the hardest word. It's sad, so sad. It's a sad situation, and it's getting more and more absurd. Thank you.
I think you added a few extra little words of your own in there. It was so sad.
He had in a few notes as well that wasn't on the original.
I don't think people are going to throw their knickers at you. Sorry, is anyone disagreeing with me? Okay. Who would like to throw their knickers at Matthew? I can't believe it. They wish you would as well. I'm not even going to go with that, Matt. Louis, yes or no?
Oh, it has to be no.
Cheryl?
No, but thanks.
Sorry, Matt. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Bye.
This is a sad day for Asda employees everywhere, Matt. Simon made some comment about women throwing their knickers at you. You wouldn't want the knickers thrown at you, would you?
Not really, no.
That's a bit grim, isn't it?
Well, thanks.
Matt, where did you get these from? So Matt failed to impress, but remember Simon's motto, guys, always stay positive.
I've got a bad feeling about this already.
Oh, that must be his new motto.
Everybody's got an appetite.
It's a no.
And I wonder.
No.
A bit best when I'm
no.
Be your hero.
This is easy.
Oh, maybe good news?
No.
And with all the...
No.
No.
No. Around, you would have thought...
No.
Just let...
No.
Can I just...
No.
Let me just...
No.
Oh, for goodness sake, are you finished?
Yes.
Thank you.
No.
Very funny. Anyway, if things don't start improving in London, Simon's new motto...
I've got a bad feeling about this.
...might just stick.
Slipping on snow while you feel alone. Suffocating dreams I could have. Maybe for a minute I'll be down.
You've got 3 yeses. Congratulations.
Absolutely yes.
Yes.
It's a yes for me.
Hi, what's your name?
My name's Grace.
Welcome to the X Factor. How old are you, Grace?
16.
If you would know I wanted, and I never get confronted with a big stick up for me. If I were a boy, I think you could understand how it feels to love a girl. I swear I'd be a better man.
Absolutely yes.
Definitely a yes from me.
I think you are incredibly talented, 100% devoted, and you could be one to watch. It's 3 yeses.
Thank you, everyone!
What's your name?
Esther.
And what song have you prepared?
Why Not Only by Jennifer Hudson.
I have no doubt that I can love you forever. The only trouble is I really don't have the time.
There's something about you, I think we like her. I'm going to say yes.
Yes.
Got three yeses. Your name is?
Geneva.
Okay, what are you going to sing today?
At Last by Etta James.
You have three S's.
So with Geneva, Esther and Grace all through to boot camp, it looks like Simon's new motto...
I've got a bad feeling about this.
...should really change to...
I used to be a Zulu tribe.
Yeah, exactly the motto I was thinking of. I think it's time to catch up with Cheryl.
Do you know what? You know when people go on stage and then they have a really embarrassing moment? I really feel for them. What's the most embarrassing moment you've ever had?
Oh, God, I've had loads. You'd be here all day, Connie.
Name me one that comes to mind.
I had a train door shut on my head once.
Really? Oh, my gosh. That was painful.
As I was kissing a new boyfriend, goodbye.
Oh, my gosh. How long ago was that?
And when I was 15, which makes it
oh, no,
worse.
That's so much worse, because you were not even old enough to sort of style it out then.
No.
You were just really humiliated. What do you think of returning acts? Is there a lot of acts that have sort of either done it before and got to the auditions or got to boot camp? We've even had acts that have got to judges' houses.
It depends, actually, because some of them are good and you're glad they came back. Quiet me a river. It's hard to say no because they've had that rejection before.
I'll let you eat your lunch.
Thank you.
Catch you later.
So, let's get back to the auditions, where events manager Tom Crocker has everything under control.
Yeah, everything's fantastic. Thousands and thousands of people keep turning up, but we're the largest venue in London and we're all hands on deck.
Hold on there, Tom. I think you might be one member of staff down.
My name is Dimitri. I'm studying the events management and I work part-time here at the Excel.
What's the accent? Where are you from?
I'm from Latvia, but I'm speaking my native language, Russian. Вы сможете узнать больше обо мне на Extra Factory после перерыва.
What do you do when you're back home in Latvia?
Actually, I'm living here, so I'm studying here.
Uh-huh.
I'm working part-time at the Excel London.
What, you work here?
I do. My job here is to set up the events, so I'm moving the chairs from one place to another. The wall panels, quite a hard physical job.
What are you studying?
I'm studying the events management.
Events management? Events management.
I like that my job brings me closer to the thing that I'm studying, the events management. But I would like to become a great performer, worldly recognized.
Hi, what's your name?
My name is Dimitri.
And where are you from, Dimitri?
Originally, I'm from Latvia, but I came here for studying and working.
Yes.
And I work here.
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
What do you do here?
It's like a porter job, but physically quite a hard job because...
Yes. What is the music scene like in Latvia at the moment?
Quite poor.
Which artists there do you like?
I'm really passionate about the Russian opera singer Dmitry Khvorostovsky. He's great.
Yeah, he is good. What's so funny about that?
You don't know him, do you?
Dmitry.
Yeah?
He's an opera singer.
Oh, really? Okay.
Well, listen, good luck.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each
and every highway and more, much more than this, I did it my way.
You know what, Dimitri? I've heard better, I've heard worse. I don't think you've got a strong enough voice for this.
Okay.
Louis, yes or no?
No, Dimitri.
Cheryl?
No, sorry.
Sorry, Dimitri, but nice to meet you.
Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
I feel good because I absolutely agree with judges. Yeah, so if I heard the same, I would say no as well.
So you're going to be back in a year's time?
Yes.
Thank you so much. Oh,
thank you.
I see you next year.
Thank you very much. See you next year.
So bad news for Dimitri, who's been sent on his way. Haven't you forgotten something, Dimitri? These chairs aren't going to stack themselves. Feel like changing channel or listening to the radio?
I'm not keen on either.
Then stay tuned, Dermot, because part three is coming up.
You can have a judge shower.
Who's the chap that fell over in front of Cheryl?
That is what's called dying on your ass.
For details on how to download the free Nokia app featuring videos and news and for exclusive behind-the-scenes clips, go to itv.com/X Factor. A guaranteed crowd-pleaser. Welcome back to The Extra Factor, where we're continuing our mad dash across the country to show you the very best auditions. We've moved on to Brum. In 2010, Birmingham was ranked the 55th most livable city in the world. Out of 56, not bad. Unlucky Baghdad. So let's celebrate with some spontaneous mass-synchronized clapping. Look, the party atmosphere's even put a smile on Simon's face. It's just another day on The Extra Factor! And as the judges arrive at the auditions, the only question is, where's Louis? Ah, that crowd outside the hotel might be a giveaway. Leave it to me.
Good morning!
Oh, Connie, I'm only out of bed.
I know. But
You look good.
You look good as well.
No, there was loads of banging in this hotel.
Oh, really?
No.
Banging as in?
I don't know who was banging. There was a lot of banging.
Really?
Upstairs
were
and
they
downstairs.
Keeping you up all night with
this
their
is
banging?
The only room there was no banging in.
Really?
Seriously.
You had no banging in here?
None at all, not yet.
No. Well, that's good, or is it bad?
It's bad. Come on in.
Can I do a little tour of Louis' room? This shower is massive.
It holds five.
Oh my gosh, it holds five. We could get all the judges in here. You can have a judge shower. Let's see, is it hard or
something? Side of bed, yes. Am I in bed with Connie?
Yes.
Am I the first?
Yes,
today.
You're the first today.
I wanted to do that.
Have you ever, been in bed with Simon?
No! Simon's getting married, Danny's having a baby, and Cheryl's divorced. What am I doing wrong?
Oh yeah, check under the
just
bed.
Just checking if there's anybody in the closet.
I can't believe Louis was kept up last night. Birmingham seems like such a peaceful place. Oh, and there's the NEC where we're doing the auditions. I love it here, so quiet at this time of year. But don't take my word for it, ask electrician Richard Wood. He looks like the quiet type.
Yeah, we're in the heart of heavy metal, Birmingham.
Whoa! What brings you here today?
I want to bring metal back to the X Factor.
I'm bringing metal back to the X Factor!
I don't think there's enough metal in the music business at the moment. Pretty much the whole 80s metal scene are my idols.
Your influences, I take it, include Poison.
Don't need nothing but a good time.
Then who else? John Bon Jovi, nice.
One day, I'm going to headline Donington, the birthplace of heavy metal. I just want to blow the shit out of everybody.
Boom!
Boom! I want to go up on stage and create chaos.
Oh!
How are you doing?
And what's your name?
Stage name, Rusty Chaos.
Okay, and where do you do Rusty Chaos?
Pretty much round Sheffield.
Yeah, Sheffield!
All right, and the song you're going to sing is called what?
Walk This Way by Aerosmith.
I was going to ask you if you've got anything by Steven Tyler.
Okay.
Come on, Birmingham! Backseat lovin', the song's undercover, and I talk to my daddy, say the days he knocked me when they're down on the muffin, and I talk to the change of ways. The dear leader has been big dick, died on the reminisce. And dancing lovin', the sister undercover, and I started with a little kiss like this.
I was waiting for a reaction like that.
I mean, that should have got 3,000 people up on their feet. I mean, it just didn't work. I mean, Richard, that is what's called dying on your ass.
I just came to rock the X Factor, really.
Okay.
No rock at all there. Yeah, the great luck and the great moves, but there was no rock and roll.
Richard, I think we should just all say goodbye, right?
Yes. Okay. Oh, wait, I've got a question for you.
Yeah.
Is there any chance I can have Bon Jovi tickets?
Yeah, why not?
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I like it. We should get some tickets.
Was it all just a ploy to get Bon Jovi tickets?
I'm gonna say yes now.
Oh, so. Right. Laters.
Thank you very much.
Oh, see
keep
ya.
Rocking. Have you well.
Rocking it out.
Yes, this is the part of the show where random strangers live together in a house isolated from the outside world, but continuously watched by television cameras. What do you mean this isn't Big Brother? Huh?
This is the part of the show where members of the public get the chance to ask presenter Supreme Dermot O'Leary any question they please. Yes, it's Delving into Dermot!
Dermot, it's the last day for auditions. What's been your favourite moment?
Well, now, thank you for your question. Who was the chap that fell over in front of Cheryl?
Oh, yeah, his name was...
Christopher Blackstud.
Wood.
Stock.
Stock.
Yes. I think you should come and give her a kiss.
Nice on the lips, though.
Yes, that was quite funny.
It was, but I kind of felt for him.
Dermot, would you rather have the head of the dolphin and the body of a human, or body of an octopus with the head of a human? It's a tough one, I know.
I'm not keen on either.
No, I don't blame you.
Body of an octopus, you're never going to get laid with the body of an octopus. Also, I wouldn't mind head of a human, body of a dolphin. I don't think how fast I could swim. Winning the Olympic gold again.
Although he's got a weird body, he's a great swimmer.
Be amazing.
Watch out, London 2012. Speaking of which, London is the next stop for us to visit on our whistle stop tour of the country. And it looks like I'm going to get a lift from Simon. Oh, right. Cheryl? Oh, yeah, bye then. Oh, there's Louis. Oh, can I get a lift from you? Oh, okay. Actually, I'm really keen to get the train there anyway. I'll meet you there. So, while I enjoy a relaxing train journey... I think it's time to meet our next contestants, and I've heard they're a real head-turner. See what I mean? All right, girls, you're going to give yourselves a headache soon. Just tell us who you are.
My name is Maria.
My name is Monica.
And we are the MS. We have got the same initials, so it's Monica Smola, Maria Smola. So we thought, just to keep it simple, short, sweet.
A little bit different.
Different.
We have good voice. We can move, so why not to win?
Yeah, I think that God gave us kind of the talent, so I think it would be just a shame to waste it.
You two
related.
We are sisters.
Singing together is our second nature because we always used to do it together, so there is no communication problem.
I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you. Maybe
see you later.
Our dream is to do in for life, for living, what you love. Yeah. I think it's a privilege. Not only a little percentage, or small percentage of population can do for a living what they love.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay, and you are, what's the name of the group?
The MS.
Okay, and you related?
Yeah, we are sisters, actually. Is it not obvious?
If I'm being honest, I thought it was mother and daughter.
Who is mother, who is daughter?
I'm not going to say. You're the mum.
Girls, where are you from?
Okay, and where are you from?
Poland.
Poland. That's where I'm from. So we could be related.
Sounds good to me.
And me. Okay, and what's the song you've chosen?
The Shup Shup song.
Okay.
Does he love me? I wanna know. How can I tell if he loves me so? Is it in his eyes?
Oh no, you'll be the sea.
Is it in his eyes?
Oh no, he'll make believe.
If you wanna know if he loves you so, it's in his keys. That's where it is. Oh yes, is it in his eyes?
It's just his arms
in his warm embrace.
Oh no, it's just his charms.
If you wanna know if he loves you so, it's in his keys. That's where it is. Oh yes, it's in his keys. That's where it is. Oh, Haki.
Thank you. I think the scary thing is that Louis would actually buy that record. I just know that. It's very you.
I was fascinated by the girls, Sammy. Yeah, I was fascinated because it was kitsch and it was old-fashioned, but I enjoyed it.
Cheryl, what do you think?
I'm actually quite taken aback by you. You're very cute.
Thank you.
Could be the new Cheeky Girls.
Yeah.
Something to look forward to. Yeah, you're fun. You know, you're not taking yourselves too seriously. One of you. Okay, Louis, yes or no?
I'd like to see you again, yes.
Thank you.
I'm gonna say no, girls.
I'm gonna say yes.
Thank you very much.
How about you and Kimberly? Right?
Which one's me?
The one on the right.
Hey! We can celebrate with some Polski chleb tonight. That's Polish bread to those of you who don't speak Polish.
Very well done.
Cheryl said that you reminded her a bit of the Cheeky Girls.
Yeah, she did. It was a compliment.
Yeah, you a fan of the Cheeky Girls?
Yeah.
Well, see you at boot camp. Yes, we will. Just as soon as we can get them to stop turning their heads to camera. Back after the break for a BAFTA-winning part four.
Very, very optimistic.
No, really, Simon, it's amazing.
Yes.
Not going to make me popular.
So I've got charm.
We're here for you.
I love you, Louis.
I'm actually going to say something.
Welcome back to The Extra Factor. We're still in Manchester, where once again the auditions have attracted thousands of people, both young and old. For some, it could be their last chance.
Pardon?
I said for some, it might be their last chance!
Building ship, yeah.
I said!
Oh, it doesn't matter.
But for others, they're hoping it's their first step on the road to success.
We'll be young forever!
So what's your name?
My name is Charlene.
Charlene?
Yeah.
And how long have you been singing for?
I can't remember, really.
Since you're about five. And how old are you now?
17.
So you're one of the youngest people taking part in the auditions.
I work as a care assistant in an elderly residential home, and I just basically look after the old people, can you look after them? So just look after them, really. I live with my mum and dad.
She's our youngest, our baby. I think the world of her. When I hear Charlene sing, I do get a lump in my throat and I get quite emotional sometimes.
Are you feeling really nervous?
A little bit. But I think I'll be more nervous when I get on the stage. I want to go out there today and really show them what I've got and make my mum and dad proud.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name?
My name's Charlene.
Are you excited to be here, Charlene?
Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous now, though.
That's okay. Don't be nervous. We're here for you.
Thank you.
How old are you, Charlene?
I'm 17.
You're 17?
Yes.
Have you ever done anything like this before?
Yeah,
like...
I auditioned 2 years ago.
Right, and what happened?
You said I want my day. I was a bit too young.
So you would have been, what, 15 then?
I was 14.
14?
Yeah.
Okay, right, so you've learned from whatever went wrong before.
Yeah, I've just become more confident.
Okay, what are you going to sing today?
I'm going to sing a Beyonce song.
You sure about this? Okay, which one?
Listen. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Did you feel that you did a good job? Yeah? Well, I think you did an amazing job, and I had no idea such a huge voice was going to come out of that little body. Those better be tears of happiness, girl.
Look, Shani, it's not going to make me popular. But I haven't said anything yet. Look, Charlene, here's where I think your problem is, OK? I think you've been like a little tiny girl singing big songs, probably getting a great reaction from your family, but it hasn't worked out in your career. Because the truth is, you don't have that kind of voice.
I think that you have an amazing voice and you have a powerful voice.
She was going to make a record now. What sort of record would she make?
I'd put her on a song with Justin Bieber and they'd do their thing.
Okay. We're going to vote. Louis, yes or no?
Charlene, on your voice and your potential, I'm saying yes.
Charlene, I'm your biggest cheerleader, girl. You can do it. I'm gonna say yes! Yes.
Look, Charlene, I was just trying to be helpful, right?
Are you saying yes or no?
Okay, look, Charlene, you've got two yeses, so my one doesn't matter.
Yeah, it does.
But for what it's worth,
it does.
I was going to say yes.
Thank
really?
Oh my gosh, Lincolnshire will be so proud. See you later, hon. Go and ring everyone. Bye.
So Charlene is through, and it's the end of our auditions. We also thought it was the end of Come Judge With Me, but it turns out that someone had other ideas.
Take five celebrities and put them on a panel of judging giants. Add a competitive twist by asking judge expert Louis Walsh to judge them.
There's no 10 makeup girls, there's no silly hairdryer.
With hilarious results.
I love you, Louis.
As they compete for the coveted prize of the highest score.
Okay, guys, it's that time of the week. It's Come Judge With Me, and this week I am going to judge myself because I am one of the most experienced judges on X Factor. I've been there for like 7 years. I've probably had the most number one records of anybody. I've definitely got the best band. I'm very low maintenance. I don't have any minors. There's nobody running around with my phone. I turn up, I just do the gig, I just show up. I'll be the most honest, down-to-earth judge. Out of 10, I'm going to give myself a very, very humble 11.
So with that late entry, he's only gone and won the whole thing. I don't know why you're looking so shocked, Louis.
I bet Simon Kerr wouldn't forget to pay my fare.
So the auditions may be over, but the competition has just begun.
Are you looking forward to boot camp this year?
Yeah, I actually am this year, yeah. Last year, I was very, very optimistic.
Does that mean that this year you're going in with a sort of lower...
No, I'm just going in with a realistic attitude.
Which category would you like this year?
It's too early to say. Mm. Honestly, when you put good people together, then you can really start spotting as to who's...
Yeah,
you know, you can go through 25 terrible auditions, somebody quite good comes on, you know, you get overly optimistic about it, and then you get disappointed. You know, we're going to do our best to get them good songs to sing, the right preparation, right team of experts around them to help them, and then we'll see.
So it's the end of the audition tour, and this week's show. This, of course, can only mean one thing.
It's time for Louis Walsh's final comment.
Yes, and eventually I'm actually going to say something properly.
Yeah, quite
so,
right too.
The best thing about the X Factor is you get the talent.
This show was a fun-packed bag of awesomeness, then just wait until you see what we've got in store for you next week when we get to boot camp!
Welcome to boot camp!
Well, hello, judges! Oh, hey.
Right, you come back next year, yeah?
Oh, kaboom!
Don't talk to me, I'm hungover. You are going home.
O-N-S-G.
Quite intimate.
It's good.
Wow, I can't wait to watch Boot Camp next week.
Ah, lovely Connie. Right then, from one ITV2 beauty to another, Fern And is on the way next with Mr. Perez Hilton, no less. It's a good one. And then Film Before Bed with the Light On, Hannibal Rising is on at 11.